maybe the most eye-catching development in printing since Gutenberg invented the printing press 600 years ago. A machine that can make copies of almost anything, but this time in 3D. It seems like science fiction, but 3D printing is already in use.
Guns. 3D printing has opened up some truly amazing things, but nobody had expected that one day we'd be able to print guns in our bedroom.
Today in Manhattan, you can wander into a 3D printing store, the only of its kind, and take home your own printer for $2,200.
Gun control for us is a fantasy. In a way that, like, people say, well, you're being unrealistic about printing a gun. I think it's more unrealistic now, especially going forward, to think you could ever control this technology.
3D printing, or additive manufacturing, works like this. A computer-aided design, or CAD file, is created. That file is then sent to a 3D printer. The printer then builds the object in the CAD file by starting at the base and applying a series of layers. At the end of the process, a 3D printed item is born. So how will the ability to self-manufacture untraceable firearms affect the gun control debate?
If we could print a gun, other people could do this. Like, what if we gave it away, open source style? What would that mean?
All the magic that the ATF loves to regulate happens right in here. So this is the firearm in commerce. None of this is serialized. You can order this right through the mail. I like fitting the clear piece to it because you can kind of see everything inside.
I truly do believe that in the next decade, the majority of Americans will have a 3D printer in their home. I truly believe that. They were printing out cups and plates and furniture and all these different things. And some of those people will be printing out weapons with that.
If I get the right gear, I could do this stuff at home.